In an era of stress and anxiety, when the present seems unstable and the future unlikely, the natural response is to retreat and withdraw from reality, taking the recourse either in fantasies of the future or in modified visions of a half-imagined past.
Of course, that means the Watchmen review.
Hey guys, welcome to Flashback.
Hello.
What we're going to talk about today is Gotham's most notorious street fighters for the good guys. So Pete, you're going to agree that Watchmen are part of Gotham City, right? Yeah? Yeah. So without further ado, let's go for it. The Watchmen review. So first up, we have Dr. Manhattan.
Do we? Game over.
There you go. If you have Dr. Manhattan on your team, you automatically win. As long as you roll a die on a 1-6, you have won. We're actually going to go for Silk Spectre.
Yeah,
not the mother.
Not the grandma. No, the mother, sorry. Yeah. So she's the joint cheapest character in the Watchmen band. 50 points.
50 rep. Zero funding. Oh, let's point out, none of them have any funding because none of them can have equipment. So, yeah.
Yeah.
There you go. They're all zero, but, you know, they work. There's only five members as well, and they are perfect up to 350 rep. Right. Yeah, tournament standard. So
it's designed as a out of the box list, really.
Pretty much, yeah.
So here she is, Silk Spectre 2, 50 points, movement 3, which I think is...
Movement 3 is okay, yeah.
Pretty good,
she,
yeah.
You can see her stats. She, for 50 points, I think she's alright. Like, she kind of sits there with a lot of other... Like, look at Damien... What's his face? Wayne.
Yeah.
So she sort of sits around the same sort of mark as him.
Yeah.
And she's got kind of similar stats, but look at her defense.
Yeah, defense 5, so tricky to pin down, yeah, not bad,
yeah.
Not bad. I mean, there's plenty of ways rotten, to drop that, but it's a good place to start, defense 5, if you don't want to be hit much.
Yeah, oh, she's fantastic for that. Yeah. So, yeah, let's run through her traits and what she does. So, first up, we've got Acrobat.
Yeah, so she's fast, that combines with her movement 3. She's not got the fast rule, which is just generally fast because of Acrobat.
She goes 12 centimeter basic instead of 10. As well as that, she gets a free jump up rule, and she can also move through characters, and she treats difficult terrain as normal terrain.
That's
so
massive,
when
yeah.
She's trying to run up buildings and do things that, like, a lot of people struggle to do, she can just do it. I mean, it is massive, you know, when even as an objective grabber, or, you know, when people are trying to block alleyways, no, she doesn't care.
Whiz through, yeah.
No she whizzes problem. Through. Like, the Acrobat's such a strong rule, and a lot of characters actually have it, but it is the difference between them getting away and being stuck.
Yeah, she's got a martial artist, so that defense 5 is pretty solid. She's not going to suffer the numerical inferiority rule.
Indeed.
Pretty good.
Yeah. So, yeah, no ganging up on her. She can take them all. She'll take them all.
Yeah. Combo with an arm, that's the one where you get 3 attacks for every 2.
Every 2, so every 2 attack counters is 3 dice even. So yeah, which is okay. Which, in fact, it's brilliant, but with her it's okay.
It's actually, strength 4 she is, so not...
She's strength 4. Her biggest drawback is she doesn't actually have a weapon there.
No.
Lack of weapon, so that just
yeah,
that means that she's doing 1 stun damage. So the combo with an arm suddenly does come into play there.
Yeah. I mean, those following along the film and stuff like that, you know, she was like quite a badass fighter. It's not massively reflected. She doesn't seem to put out a lot of damage. But moving on, she's got counter attack. So for every time she's hit, I think, is it spend a special on every time you block an attack?
Yeah.
You get to immediately make a counter attack against that guy.
It's spend special and. Everything that you defended against their attacks, you will get to counter.
So it's one special for
one
the
special.
Whole hit, right?
Yeah,
for
the whole it's, bunch. Do you know what? It's tactically throwing her forwards, and you stick. She's got will. Oh, she's got willpower 6, but you stick 4 in defense there, 1 in 1 in special. Anyone who tries to hit her, she can really hit them back hard.
Yeah,
but
not that hard.
No, I don't think the combo stacks either. There,
Does it know where the combo does kick in?
No, I think the combo is
counter-attack, so.
Could be wrong. Disclaimer there somewhere. But no, I don't think it does. I think combo only works. Oh, sorry. The combo with an arm only works when you're actually attacking.
You're actively attacking. Okay.
Yeah. And then her last one is close combat master.
Yeah, and it's written on the card. She is, and I quote, able to repeat disarmed hit rolls. And what we think that means is she's got handy, but only if she's not carrying a weapon. I can't think of a way where she'd ever get a weapon. So, as far as we can tell, it means handy.
Well, yeah, the wording is using repeat disarmed hit rolls is kind of confusing, because what's a disarmed hit roll?
It could mean, and I am guessing now, I'll admit it, is if she's trying, can you, is there a mechanism in the game to disarm somebody? There's not really, is there?
Thief?
Yeah, she's not got thief, I don't know. I'm not sure. It seems to be just a complicated way of putting it handy, but there we go.
Yeah. Well, we've treated it as handy because it seems like that's what it's trying to say.
Yeah.
All right. But overall, I'll tell you what, for 50 points, she's pretty solid.
Not bad.
She doesn't hit quite hard enough, but she defends very well.
Yeah,
she's... The acrobat, she gets dodge as well. And with defense 5 and acrobat... So
and movement 3.
And movement 3. Sticking things in movement, she can actually dodge bullets.
Yeah.
Pretty effectively.
And that's an agility roll, isn't it? So yeah. 3 or less, you dodge your bullets. So not bad.
She's pretty tough.
Yeah.
She is. Defense 5 is just like, what's the point in even trying to hit her?
You almost feel like the flavour of this character is the distractor, you know, the one who will run about and distract and take all the hits and while the other guys get on with their thing. Cool.
Alright, and let's go to our next character, Night Owl. Okay, so Night Owl, you can see, stat-wise, he's quite different from Silk Spectre 2.
Yeah. Movement 2 this time. 50 points of reputation, again, same thing. Attack 3.
Attack 3, which... Attack 3, I think he's...
Less than she was, yeah. Not great.
Defense 4.
Defense 4, where she was 5. I don't want to, we don't want to obsess over comparing the two. He's endurance 6, so he's a bit longer lasting. In theory, special 3 is everybody is. Strength 5 plus this guy.
Oh, it's 4 plus. That was errated.
Was it? Oh, that's good. That's a good idea.
So we got through. He's got shurikens.
Yeah.
Can I just point out, I'll jump to this now. If he's attacking normally, he does 1 damage. Because his attack at he's attacked 3. His rate of fire 2 almost makes his shurikens much stronger than he is.
Mm.
Now, he can't use a bone breaker with it, which we'll get through in a bit, but his shurikens nearly make him a better attack than his normal attack.
Yeah, he only got 2 ammo on that. Mind you, it's rate of fire 2 as well, so...
Rate of fire 2 and throwing, so he can run and shoot these. I found that these shurikens can be, against the right opponent, can be balls.
Yeah.
Really good.
Yeah, not bad.
So, we'll go into his rules then. He's got Brutal.
Yeah, just reroll your cholesterol damage dice.
Yeah, so when you hit people, you can actually hit them harder. Let's jump straight into his Bone Breaker rule then.
Yeah.
So, you can spend 1 special from your attack as well, which allows the Bone Breaker to crit double blood. Now, that is really good because he's got Brutal. So he's actually got a 1 in 3 chance of getting off a double blood with that. Mm. Obviously, like, it costs a special, which kind of heavy going since he's only willpower 6, because suddenly you're a bit like, oh, I don't know where, if you've got 3 in attack and 3 in defense, what are you taking off?
Yeah.
So in that regard, he's not fantastic.
He's got no sorts of rerolls, has he, to hit, so you'd be probably gambling on taking it from defense.
Yeah.
Depending on how important it was to get those 2 blood on that guy,
He's only strength 4 as well. So he's not even guaranteed to get any wounds off.
Mm.
So he's okay, but let's go through his bat cape. What does that do?
That you can fall at any distance without damage.
Yeah, you can just jump off the building, spend a special. He doesn't die, or he doesn't have to take a roll. I keep thinking that bat cape should have more rules to it.
Yeah, you said you think it should be possibly. I will put that into what we want to see, maybe. But, it should have a role in close combat, if you do it.
Oh, no, I think shooting.
Oh, shooting, dodging the bullets, right?
Yeah. I mean, how many episodes of Batman have you seen that people have a machine gun shooting at them and Batman's done the whole, I throw my cloak around.
I'm moving around.
People can't see
him. You can't hit me.
I think it should cost you, like, it should cost a special, and for that attack on him, it should be minus one, or maybe minus one to hit him.
Yeah.
For just attack, but then maybe it's broken with Batman because he's generally defense 5. But you know what? If Batman's going to be putting him in special counters, or, you know, he's not using him in attack or defense. Just spitballing here.
Yeah.
All right. Well, so Batcave, as it stands, you jump off a building.
Yeah.
And so it's.
Is it okay? He can get you out of a attack, you know, if you need to get somewhere fast or something.
Yeah. He can get onto a building.
He's not got a bat claw, has he?
No, but he can start on a building. But we'll go into that in a sec.
Yeah, he can drop onto a building.
So we got total vision with him. I know why he has total vision.
Why?
Because in the comic scenes.
Oh, yeah.
Goggles are like, I can see. This is how John must see.
Yeah. But it doesn't actually help him in any way, shape, or form.
No,
he's only got short range throws.
He's immune to sneak attack.
Okay. Yeah. Well, round the corner.
Yeah. I don't know. I don't know. Total vision was kind of a light one on him.
Yeah, it's a fluff thing. It's got to be in there because he's got those magic glasses in the film, hasn't he? So, no problem.
And probably his best ability is...
Arrest.
Oh. I'll tell you why it's the best, because no one else on the team has the ability to do that.
Yeah.
And I found that typically he will go last, and he will just go last to arrest the person that everyone else has beaten up.
Yeah.
Everyone else has more punching power and more ability than him. So he's actually a good one to... He sits back. If he needs to attack, go with the shurikens. If he doesn't, whatever, he can arrest people.
Yeah.
So one movement, one special. It's a little bit costly on his willpower for a guy who's putting willpower all over the place anyway. But at the same time, it works with him.
No, he's taking somebody out, the game altogether. It's well worth it.
Okay, and he's got a powerful, powerful rule.
Archie, which is his round spaceship thing that he hovers around in the movies and comics. Go through this side because you're the expert on this one.
Archie, typically... to start, when you're actually putting down your counters at the start of a phase, you decide he will come on right here. He comes on where he likes, you know, you just put him down and that's where he comes on. It's brilliant because for the first three turns of a game, you typically shouldn't put Night Owl in there. He doesn't need to actually come on straight away. He will generally lose against a fight against anything, mm-hmm. anything, I'd say. But later on in the game, when you actually really need him, you pop him down, you can block shots.
Sweep in and do his arrest.
He sweeps in, he does arrest. He really can do a lot of late damage. He could even, you know, if you need to, everyone's left the deployment zone, there's an objective sitting there, he could come in and take them.
Yeah.
It's a bit expensive to do that, but...
Something that needs to be done sometimes.
Yeah. He has a lot of options, that's what he does.
Yeah.
Okay, and let's move on to the comedian. Comedian. So with this guy, you can see his stats again are quite different from the other, the rest of the gang. In fact, everything's quite different. His movement 2 is nothing to boast about, but his attack and defense 4 and 3, retrospectively, are a little bit, perhaps low for 75 points.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, you do get endurance 9.
Endurance 9 did really bump it up, but a defense 3 means he does get hit. He takes a bit of punishment while.
Let's get hit, yeah. Mm. But moving into the traits, one of his traits is hardened. So hardened is where the first blood, every single round, the first blood damage he takes is actually a stun instead.
Yeah.
So just blood you can't get rid of at the moment in the the game, but the stuns, you can shake those off, so that just, you know, gives them a little bit more longevity, I think.
Yeah. It does, but like this endurance 9, he's got willpower 7.
Yeah.
So he can actually, he takes quite a lot of damage before he actually, his willpower becomes pretty much nothing.
Mm.
He, like when he takes 8 damage, his willpower 3.
That's true, yeah, his counters will have dropped. So,
at least his endurance 9 still to actually shake off a test to stand up.
Yeah.
So, I mean, this guy, he doesn't go down easily, but you know, when you try and get him, he's gone.
Yeah. I mean, if he's KO'd, he's very likely to get up again, isn't he? Or at least wake up, I should say.
Let's talk about some of his traits then.
Yeah.
He's got Dimensional Laugh, one of Pete's favourite here.
Yeah.
Joke.
Distract, clown laughter, whatever you want to call it. I think the fluff behind this one is he jives, talks to people and annoys them, so they're so confused they don't know what's going on.
He does.
The effect's the same in the game. You lose a defence, but you can only do that to somebody who wants to put a rank on.
Yeah, one we've got from a special, it's one within 10 centimetres. Brilliant. It actually makes him one of the best characters to activate first, because he can go in, do this, and actually really make everyone else easier to hit this person.
It really counts with these guys, because there's only 5 of them. You've only got 5 models, so
exactly.
you need to maximise your attack. Veteran, that's the move 2 of your counters.
Move 2 of your counters, so you've deployed and you put them down and you've put a move and a special in, and the turn started and they've run into you. And, you know, you want more an attack. Move 2 of your counters around so you can have more attack. It's a veteran is very good. It's a little odd that he has it and none of the other ones have it, but
it's just because the name of the rule. The rule is called veteran, and he was in the Vietnam War.
Yeah.
That's why it's like fluff reasons.
Well, but it's. I mean, you know, not complaining. It's a.
No, no.
It's a good rule on him.
Yeah.
They should all have it, but he has it.
Harden, we went through yet, so he's taking a few less bloods and a few more stuns along the way.
Uh-huh.
Dirty Fighter is to do with shooting, isn't it?
He shoots. Oh, we should go. Let's run through his guns, actually. He's got 2 guns. He's got a riot gun and a 50 cal gun. So the riot gun has a rate of fire 1 and a medium range and 2 ammo. They both got 2 ammo each. And the 50 cal has a short range. The big difference I find with them is the riot shotgun. The medium range makes all the difference.
Yeah.
I found with the 50 cal gun, he can't actually, you're better off just running in and pounding people with your fist.
At short range, you're nearly always going to have to move to get into short range.
Short range.
And then you lose your rate of fire and all that.
I don't think it's, I'm kind of a bit disappointed with this short range gun. I don't see the point.
Yeah.
Two blood is obviously brilliant, but.
It's kind of, it's a bit opportunistic, I should say, you know.
Sacrifice all those attacks for that, it just feels a bit.
There'll be a time when you'll be really glad you've got it, but it'll be quite rare, I think, it'll be rare circumstances.
The riot shotgun, on the other hand, 3 stun.
3 stun.
That doesn't sound like much, but you know what?
With Owl floating around with the rest, 3 stun is not to be sneezed at, it's only rate of fire 1, but
doesn't matter.
You can ruin a henchman.
If you're not in range
to stay with that.
You're not in range of someone, you just move them, you take that shot. Yeah. You hit them, you've really hurt them.
It's good.
I think
it's got crit shock as well. I don't know what crit shock does.
Crit shock is when they lose all their action counters. So
it's not. It's a cheeky gun. This is the gun I was speaking about.
I think it's really good. Right, back to his traits then, or rather his reinforced gloves, which are sort of a weapon.
Yeah.
They're the old typical
two stun.
So every this is what I was comparing with 50 cal gun. So every punch he does with reinforced gloves is 2 stun versus the 2 blood. But he can load up his attack with 4 attack, and he hits hard then.
Yeah.
He really does hit hard, and I'm a bit like, well, why would you use a 50 cal gun when you don't get as many shots?
In terms of knocking people out, which is what you want with a guy with the rest floating around, stuns are as good as bloods, aren't they, really?
Pretty much, yeah.
It's great. Shooter, that's ignore a single blink during a shot. You have to declare before the shot which blink you're ignoring.
Is it any blink or is that the first one?
It's any blink. You have to choose. I don't know why. Well, I guess you get different blinks, don't you?
Yeah.
It might be a 4 up and a 5 up, and you say, I'm going to ignore the 4 up. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's how it works.
Yeah, I actually find that that's pretty strong in him.
Yeah.
Because there's a lot of. Obstacles should be en masse, really.
Yeah.
When you put a character in the way.
I think Deadshot's got something similar, hasn't he?
Yes, he does.
I've been caught out by that. I'm thinking he's not going to take that shot. over that fence and round that thing, and then
you're right, because a lot of characters, such as, you know, you come up here and you sit on top of the roof, and then they'd say, oh, you know what, I'm kneeling down, so I get plus one to my blink roll.
Yeah,
shooter just fine. Says, a shooter says, I don't care, I'll ignore that 3+ blink.
Yeah, yeah.
So, yeah.
At Psycho, that'll be the character's willpower is never altered for any reason.
That's right. So it does nothing at the moment, but I don't know. I have a feeling that Psycho is going to come into play one day. I think there's going to be... something's going to happen sometime. Perhaps in your rulebook. Who knows? But I think Psycho is going to really push the game somewhere.
It's a mystery to me why that's in there. If we're reading it right, assuming we're reading it right.
Oh, yeah. We are.
I mean, when I first read it, and I didn't read it properly, you know, months ago, it was like, oh, this guy never loses any counters, but there's another rule for that, isn't there? Which is, I can't remember what it is, but there's another rule where people who are damaged don't lose any counters.
Mm.
And I assumed that was this, but it's not. It's the willpower is never affected.
You're talking about insensitive?
Yeah, I think so, yeah. But we'll look forward to finding out what this rule is going to be used for in the future.
Yeah. One day, someone will go, I'm Psycho, brilliant. But for now, whatever. Okay, let's move on to everyone's favourite, Rorschach.
He's dead, Rorschach. While everyone's distracted, we thought we'd bring you a little housewarming gift. Something from the machine shop.
Hey, boss, you notice? None of that small world tall autocrat, because he knows once we slice open his lock, he's next on the block.
Fat chance.
Good damn, Rorschach! We got a prison full of killers out here. What do you got?
Your hands. My pleasure.
So now we're on to Walter Kovacs. So let's look through his stats. What do you think?
Yeah, 75 points, same as Comedian, so yeah, not cheap. He has got movement 3, nimble, it would suggest, attack 4, defense 4, balance, slightly better than Comedian, I think, from memory. Endurance 7, though, so he's not super.
He's a little bit more fragile there.
Yeah, and going into this, strength 4, which is okay, it's not bad. Strength 4?
All of them are strength 4 except for Azuman Dias.
Right.
So, yeah.
Yeah.
We'll go on to. He's got an improvised weapon. That now is really good. It's got Handy and Crit Blood.
Crit Blood and Blood Stun, so.
Blood Stun, he actually is the only one in the Watchmen doing this real blood damage all over the place.
It's almost as if, he's got attack 4, defense 4, his damage is Blood Stun. He's kind of like got one of each, split down the middle, dare I suggest it, you know.
If you are defending against several other characters, he's the one to watch out for, because he is going to hit you, and he's going to do the most damage.
Yeah.
So I'd be really careful about him. He's also got the Brutal rule, so he can potentially do that free reroll and get
the Crit Blood,
yeah. He is disgusting. He's really good, and he is actually more nimble because he's got the bat claw, which is he's got the 30-centimeter teleport. You know, he was on the roof and now he's down there and he's on the roof the next turn again.
Yeah.
So he has that rule which just says he can do what he likes.
Ace, the streets are extended gutters, and the gutters are full of blood. And when the drains finally scab over, all the vermin will drown. The accumulated filth of all their sex and murder will foam up around their waists. And all the whores and politicians will look up and shout, save us. And I'll whisper, no.
At that point, you should have a look at Bloodthirsty. He's got Bloodthirsty, so if he zooms down with his back door and starts attacking somebody, I believe that means he needs to keep it.
No, that's obsessive. Bloodthirsty is when he gets wounded, he gets plus one into his.
So that just makes him.
Into his attack. Now, if this is a free counter, so he essentially becomes willpower 8.
Yeah.
yeah, he becomes willpower 8, but one has to be stuck in his attack.
So they'd be 5 counters in attack then, as soon as he takes a storm.
Yeah, it has to be maxed out at 4.
Alright, okay. Yeah.
But it's a free counter. Although I found that if you're typically attacking him and he gets hit, then he's going to start dropping his willpower anyway.
Right.
So you can't have it all, but if he takes one hit, that's his favourite position to be in.
Yep.
Okay, you've got hidden. What that means?
Deploy anywhere in the playing area, I believe.
Yep, start a game, he put him down. Oh,
he's been hiding in a dustbin for 3 hours before the battle started, and out he pops, anywhere you like.
Anywhere you like, yeah, the typical rules, so you still have to be, whatever, 10 away from your objectives and whatever. But, you know, it gives him a lot of options. You can threaten your opponent straight away that I've put him here, that you don't want to come near me, and, you know, that that does sort of pull a lot of people off, that, you know, you've got someone who's a bit too close to you.
Mm.
Especially with his damage output, you can't just have your Kalashnikov guy just running around and just get assaulted by him.
Yeah.
So,
yeah. Well, in the scenario where people pop up in different places around the board, this, you know, that he's brilliant in that scenario. He's gonna be great there because he can just pop up and pick off that.
He goes and helps whoever. Yeah.
Not bad.
Yeah, some good stories about that one.
Yeah, and coming up, no doubt. And then detective, so he can cancel a pass the opponent's got. Which is nice.
There's some rule with detective coming out that says he can. Detective's got to do something to do with the riddles as well.
It always crosses my mind that when I read detective, I think surely a detective should be somebody who can figure out a riddle more easily.
I think that's coming out.
Yeah.
If not, make it so.
Yeah.
It should happen. So I'm looking forward to seeing what happens with that as well.
So Rorschach's pretty good. He's a teleporter, as we said, with the backclaw. He's
backclaw and hidden and a brutal weapon. He can just do what he likes. He's anywhere he wants to be. He's actually really good.
Yeah.
I really rate him. And let's go on to our last character, Ozymand Dice. So now we're going to talk about Adrian Veidt.
Ozymand Dice, the King of Kings.
So this guy is 100 points and he is a beast.
He's expensive, yeah. When we first saw this guy, we looked at him and thought, 100 points? What do you get for 100 points? It doesn't seem to be worth it, but it's one of those cases where you can theory something, you know, look at the card and come to a conclusion, and then you play test it a little bit and you find out where the strength
is. He's good. He's a match for anyone. He is.
Yeah, so he's 100 points. He's got movement 4, which is unusually high movement value.
Extremely.
It becomes apparent why that is when you take into account the fact that he's got Acrobat.
Acrobat, so he can dodge bullets, but you know what? He's also got reflexes.
Reflexes, where he can re-roll his agility rolls, which is what you make to dodge a bullet. So basically, you roll in 1, 2, 3, 4 to dodge a bullet. If you fail, you can re-roll it once. That's awesome. Suddenly, it's very hard to hit with guns.
No one's going to shoot. Other point is he's defense 5 with martial arts, so numerical inferiority.
No use against this guy. Defense 5, so you've got to roll 5-6 to hit him.
5, even shooting at him though, he's trying to roll 5s and then he can dodge it. And if you're trying to outnumber him, attack him with those guys, he doesn't care because you're strength 5.
The one hope you've got is maybe distract if you've got that. You know, that's
distract is good. Yeah.
Even so. Okay, endurance 8. Is huge. He's also willpower 8.
Willpower and an endurance 8, so he's massive. He's up there with Batman, really. You know, he is brilliant.
And his weak one?
Oh well, another strength point is his strength 3. His weak point is probably that he's attack 4, which means that opponents have a 50% chance of, you know, yeah, whatever, you can't hit me.
Yeah.
He's also got no handy, so he doesn't have any rerolls of any sort. He's just going in there, relying on the trick that comedian's thrown forward. So comedian can distract someone, he can go in afterwards and he can actually hit them easier.
Yeah.
But he's really, otherwise he's a bit blind. He just,
yeah, I mean, with no reroll, he's gonna hit maybe two or three times if you're lucky, depending on who you're hitting.
Even a defense 3 character, I found that, you know, he might not even get it through.
He struggle, yeah. Okay. He's got reinforced gloves if he does manage it, so two stun each time.
Two stun, so that's where his strength is. He's the same damage output as a comedian.
Yeah.
He's really good for not getting hit in the first place.
That's the strength of him, yeah. He's lightning fast, he's cartwheeling on the spot, you can't shoot him, you can't punch him very easily, you know. And as we'll get to later, you probably don't want to bother wasting your energy trying it.
And we're going to put these two together. He's got Mastermind and Great Strategist. So Mastermind, you add a counter to the pot.
Yeah,
For better or for worse. It's not always good if you're losing with Watchmen, you're really going to lose probably.
Yeah, you might not want that extra turn. It won't always help you.
And the Great Strategist adds 2 points on to your strategies. So you're going to have to start with 5 points, not 3.
It's a real good argument, this, for why any future tournaments should probably keep the scenarios in. Because this guy would be wasting a lot of his resources if we weren't using scenario. So scenarios are a go for tournaments.
Oh, I think so.
Yeah,
definitely.
Your turn, Doctor. Tell me. What do you see?
In this segment, we'll talk about how to play Watchmen. So, first of all, Pete wants to talk about how not to play them.
How not to play them, yeah. I think I was the first one of us to try them out a few weeks ago. I was up against League of Shadows, wasn't I? Ra's al Ghul and Film Bane, Dark Knight Rises Bane.
Yeah.
I was all excited about the fact that Rorschach can do his back claw and he can deploy anywhere on the battlefield, and Night Owl can drop down in later turns. I think, remembering Night Owl dropped down near a lone henchman and they battled over an objective and Night Owl failed to do anything.
Night Owl loses to everybody.
Yeah. Rorschach, I forget what he did. He was messing about, floating around on his own, and got caught out, did he? Did he get caught
down? Yeah, you basically came down too quickly. You came at me, you fed me, I killed someone, and then I left you.
Yeah.
And then you had to commit to me, and I just said you're gone.
Yeah. So what it was, I did not grasp the synergies of these guys at all. I was assuming each one was a mini army, you know, or can look after himself, and they've really got to hang together, these guys, you know, and sort of look after each other.
That's
work towards the same goal, which is
How to play them, right? I've been using them for a while, and I've run through how not to use them a few times as well, what you don't want to do is you don't want to stick Night Owl out on his own too early unless he's really critically needed over there. He doesn't need to come in for the first 3 or 4 turns, you know. You can delay that order, you can keep save up these passes, you can really do that. Another point is Rorschach, you want to not just put him into the fray straight away. He's got hidden, so he really can. He's a great fighter. You might be tempted to stick him in, bull charge himself in, but the rest of your force, the other 3 guys, they're just running in and they're doing their best. You've fallen for the trap yourself if you do that, and it's your own fault because you've committed to the trap too quickly.
Yeah, and Rorschach's got to watch out for guns as well, hasn't he? He's floating around on top of buildings and stuff, and he can be shot down. If all those guns have got nobody else to shoot at, because he's early game.
Yeah, he's somewhat vulnerable, so you have to plan this. So typically what I've been doing is, with the 5 strategy points, I've decided that an informer is definitely needed. That's 2 points. The other one I take is the early bird, so you get to choose who goes first. Absolutely vital, because it's important that you get first pick or the second pick. if you don't need to go first, great, you can force the opponent to go first.
Yeah.
And the other one, I'd actually make the objectives move. So the whole point of this is
linked together,
so you can actually have the game starting pretty much what I'd be doing is on setting up, you're going to split your band in two. Rorschach and Night Owl, you put them in one half and you put the other three in the other half. The other three are going to come down. They have to do the same thing anyway. They have to band together. Hidden and the Archimedes, Archie, one can start where he likes and one doesn't have to start on the board. So that's what you're going to do straight away. You're going to split them up like that. Rorschach's actually a pretty good one to go and rob loot straight away. Because what you're going to do is you're going to have them somewhere within that 10 centimeters of the loot somewhere. If you're going to take the first turn, the loot's going to come towards you in the 2d6. You can use a d6 to put yourself forwards and then, you know, back claw yourself away.
Yeah.
And straight away your opponent is chasing you because you've got an objective.
Yeah.
And Rorschach can do this. Get yourself all the way back to where your opponent was.
Yeah.
You know, where you can set up a trap. You're generating points straight away from turn one.
And that's a massive psychological thing, isn't it? Suddenly, turn one, it's very possible that the other guy's not had a turn or activated anything yet. Yes. Already, he's got a VP.
You've got the loot, you've run away.
Yeah.
And a lot of the times, you know,
it's really important how that will tilt people's brain a bit. And
it does.
Oh, I've lost this, you know, so I'm losing.
While this is happening, you've set it up so the other three guys are all getting ready for this fight to inevitably happen because you're generating the VPs. So they're coming for you. And what's going to happen is you're going to meet. What you need to do then is you need to get Silk Spectre out there. She has to be the first one into the fray. Now the reason for this is because she's got counterattack, a high defense, and she's got every option to dodge bullets and people.
Yeah.
She's also got the least attack, so get ready to use your passes. Use them en masse, right? As well as that, if you don't have Night Owl in there, get ready, pass, okay? And you are trying to force them to do as much as possible in those two passes you have. Put Silk Spectre forwards. Get ready with a counter attack. Okay, you get a lot of defense and a counter attack.
Yeah,
get
ready countering special. Yeah,
get ready to attack to counter attack that person you need to actually hit. Okay?
Yeah, yeah.
So just save them up. She can even take a hit or two. It doesn't matter because what will happen is as soon as the opponent's committed, she can actually she can hit back a little bit. But it's the other guys who can actually hit even harder.
Yeah.
So you got Azumandaz and Comedian. They are both ready as serious backup for her, like when it's needed. And at the same time, you've got Rorschach is actually ready there to, he can actually at some point, he could probably drop the loot and go in and he can hit even harder.
Mm-hmm.
But make sure he's not vulnerable at the time because he can perhaps be a little bit
Yeah, you need to be careful where you park him. Yeah, don't
park him. He can get outnumbered and he can get shot. So be careful you don't put him into lines of traffic going on. But you know, Ozymandias is actually the most survivable character out of them.
Yeah.
And he can just walk through characters because he's got acrobats, so he can walk through them and hit really hard.
Yeah.
That's generally it. The nice thing about Comedian is he can actually shoot. He's got option of his two guns, and he's a really heavy hitter, so he should be the last one in. But he should be the last one in, and then when he's in there, then he starts doing distract.
Well, he should be around for distract, shouldn't he, anyway?
Definitely.
Somewhere certainly. Around, yeah. And that helps Ozzy hit a bit harder.
So, I suppose
it's a pretty nice plan, isn't it? And it served you well at a recent tournament, didn't it?
Yeah. It did, yeah. The general plan is you are trying to set up a trap for your opponent.
Yeah.
And
it's literally hook, line and sinker, isn't it? It's like hook the loot, bring it in, they come dashing after you, or give up. Straight away and just flounder,
yeah.
And then he come in and then it's like bang, 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 bang. It's brilliant.
Yep.
Good plan.
And following up from that, let's talk about how to beat them.
It's a joke. It's all a joke. Oh, forgive me.
And forevermore, that's how you stay. That's why, darling, it's incredible that someone so unforgettable thinks that I'm unforgettable too.
Okay, so we just talked about some tactics about how they would win a game. Let's talk about how they'd lose a game as well. So typically what we're saying earlier about what Pete was doing, making mistakes with Watchmen is crucial. If you put the guys in too early, or you commit to attack that you are not going to win, you are going to lose. A heavy thing about Watchmen is they have no henchmen, and each member of their crew is so valuable that if one of them gets hurt or damaged or falls over too early,
yeah,
it can really impact on the whole game. So how to beat them? What I would typically do is ignore Ozzy, full stop.
Because you can't hurt
him. Because you're not going to hurt him. Now, I mean, that's not to say never go for him. Of course, go for him.
He's the last guy standing.
He's the last
that's
one.
That's about the time.
I would also say ignore Silk Spectre.
Which is similar, but a diet version of him.
If you want to hit Rorschach or Chameleon.
Yeah.
They're the two that you want to go for. If you can hit, if
and
you can
knock over, biggest damage output as well, aren't they?
They're the two big damage outputs. If you can knock over or hit one of them, I mean, you can really impact the entire mentality of the Watchmen player.
Yeah,
they're going to really feel that, oh, this is terrible. They're going down. There's only a certain amount of turns left. Ignore Silk Spectre. She doesn't do enough damage. Also, if she's running forwards with all her defense counters sitting in there and one special. Whatever, you don't have to hit
her. She's not doing anything.
Yeah, she's not doing anything. So, you know, you can ignore her, and even if she does anything, she's going to do one stun damage. You don't have to care. Same with Night Owl. I found his attack 3 is his weak point. When he comes down, he is going to fight a henchman and have difficulty winning against him. So,
he's got the old Bone Breaker, which looks like a huge threat, but it never really materialized.
He doesn't have enough willpower to actually do anything.
Counters to really do it properly.
And once
consistently,
once Night Owl's down somewhere, he's committed. He can block him in. He doesn't have an acrobat. He has no way out.
He's not a back claw.
No. So he gets stuck. He gets killed. He always dies. And he's a good one to kill because he's got the arrest rule. In terms, basically, you want to hit. I think Rorschach's the easiest one to just knock out, kill. If you can get, you know, rate of fire one, move your guy, shoot him. Shotgun guy, he's terrified of anyone who can actually shoot him because he has no protection against that. So knock over Rorschach, knock over Chameleon, then you probably want to go for Night Owl, and then you probably want to go for Ozzy. I wouldn't even bother with the girl, Silk Spectre. She just doesn't do anything. Just, you know, she doesn't do enough. And then, you know, the player might get frustrated then and end up putting all her things in attack. Then suddenly you can actually hit her. She doesn't have enough endurance. She has no endurance either, so endurance 5.
I mean, outnumbered, she's a bit. I know she's got martial artists, but even outnumbered, she will eventually fall over.
Well, same with Ozzy. Yeah. But you just have to keep on hitting them.
Yeah.
But in terms of
sharp, handy is always a good thing.
Handy's a way to get them.
Yeah.
Another good thing is anything. Any templates that automatically hit them, they really hate that. If you have the Joker teeth, Joker face,
yeah.
You get throw Joker face at Ozzy.
Joker bombs.
He can't do anything about that. He suddenly loses the willpower for nothing.
Penguin shotgun that would make
Penguin shotgun any
very sad.
Poison
things. Yeah.
Yeah. Any templates. They
because
really
very often there's two or three of them together, isn't there? One nearby to each other. So.
Well as that, templates make Watchmen have to spread out, have to not commit to this their usual game plan, and they end up that'll actually create mistakes in that crew. So yeah, it's a good one.
As a result of the Soviet activity. The watchdog group of nuclear scientists move the doomsday clock up to 5 minutes until midnight. Destruction by nuclear war.
Dr. Manhattan model all the way.
Yeah, the model, yeah. There's loads of models they've done that have got no rules and don't need them because they're awesome models. So yeah, let's have a
Dr. Manhattan.
So I've been tasked to make one, haven't I? Or convert one up and I'm like,
Do it.
I thought it'd be easy, but it's not. So yeah, that's a work in progress.
And we need the Link's dog things as well.
Yes.
Let's see some of
that. Yeah, yeah. Ozymandias' dogs or dog. I only remember one of them by now.
It'd be nice if there's 50 points or something else that we could put in there. But you know what? At the same time, it's kind of good without.
Having said all that, it does feel like a complete set, you know, it's the five Watchmen, the five active, non-silly, if you like, Watchmen in terms of game rules. The squad's probably done, isn't it? But
it's good.
That's what we have.
Mr. Veit, to date, you're one of only two Watchmen ever to reveal their true identity to the world, the first being Hollis Mason. And you've certainly profited greatly by it. turning your superhero alter ego, Ozymandias, into a billion-dollar industry.
Hey guys, cheers for watching. Please check out the bat-builder.com. It's a free army builder for Batman.
Really good rules reference as well.
We're trying to constantly update it. We've got an affiliate shop on there. Please check them out. The more you do, the more you're helping us to actually make more videos and to actually sponsor the entire thing that's going. We're not asking for much. We're trying to do our best, you know, give you as much free stuff as possible, and we'll keep these tutorials, video reviews, and whatever you guys want coming. Please, right below, like us and tell us what you think. What do you want to see next? Cheers, guys.
Bye.